Alrighty, so this thing has been half topped off, which is absolutely insane. I was there in time to catch the process, the entire process of them hooking up this, what's like a pre-drop, a block break, and a first turn part that connects all the way to column 7 for the drop. So this thing is officially the tallest dive coaster in the world as of now, as of like probably about an hour ago. I was out there for what was 3.5 hours, 4 hours. Oh, it was so cold, but I had to film the entire process. So what you're seeing is 13 minutes of footage that was edited down from about a good hour and a half of footage. So hopefully you guys enjoy. I, for the first time ever, used my CyberShot camera to grab some still images. That is something I have not done in a very long time. I don't even think I've used my camera to grab still images. And I was beyond impressed. So once this video is released, I'm trying the YouTube premiere today, by the way. So hopefully you guys enjoy this little interaction while you guys are watching, if you're watching live. So I guess at this point I should promote the fact, hit that notification bell, because I'm going to be doing the YouTube premiere for videos now, where I'll be watching along with you guys right when I publish it. So if you guys enjoy that, but I was blown away by the camera quality that this camera has. So when you guys see these pictures on our Facebook group and our Instagram page, you're going to be blown away. It's almost as if we were right there underneath the coaster. So as you can tell, column 7's up. You can see column 7 like in the skyline from so far away. It like towers over the mountain. It towers over everything. When you are driving on the highway, if you live in the area, drive around the park. You have to see this thing. These videos and these images and all these construction updates that everyone does do not do this thing justice. This thing is massive. You can see it from everywhere. I literally was fangirling so hard on our Discord server while I was driving around the park. This is one of my favorite shots I got, I think, today. Seeing this guy so brave, towering up alongside Yukon Striker was just insane. So as you see it, like, this guy must have been so brave. It was windy, by the way. When I was flying my drone, I was having a little bit of difficulties, not as much as the other day. It was definitely a lot easier to fly today than the other day, but it was windy. It was windy, it was cold. Huge kudos to the construction team and the iron workers for working today, like, in getting this thing set up. That was beyond impressive. I am so in love with Yukon Striker, by the way. For those of you that don't know, I am so in love with Yukon Striker. Not in love, like, emotionally, but I just love filming and watching this thing being put together. It's absolutely amazing. This is my first construction project that I've watched in depth, and I absolutely love it. I mean, I love that you guys love it. I love it. The park loves it. So it's just awesome. It's just altogether awesome. By the way, we have a huge surprise for November, so stay tuned. The channel is creeping up to 10,000 subscribers, and we have a huge surprise for that once we hit it. So not only do we have a huge surprise in terms of a giveaway for you guys, it's probably going to, I don't want to speak too soon, but I think this might be the biggest giveaway a YouTube channel in the coaster community has ever done. Not to spoil anything, but take that as you will. And secondly, we have the huge channel transformation starting on November 3rd. So Amusement Insiders is transforming into something, not different, but more broad, and take that as a teaser. So, hopefully you guys enjoy that too. There's going to be a lot of awesome content over the winter. I am working on some final details, for Toronto stuff. But yeah, hopefully you guys really enjoy it. There's going to be some stuff from different cities and all that coming to Amusement Insiders over the winter, just to give you guys some fresh, new stuff to do, like, and watch through the winter. Like, most coaster channels die in the winter, and this is not going to be the case for Amusement Insiders. We have behind-the-scenes tours through winter, we have construction updates with the drone through winter, and we have all the new fresh content coming through the winter, along with our speculation videos still remaining. Nothing's changing, just adding. So hopefully you guys enjoyed that too. But at this point, we were getting close. So the crane, they were bolting in or getting close to bolting in the drop and the pre-drop together. And then they start, once they did that, they started lowering this back half onto column 7. So they first hooked this part up and then bolted it in. And you could hear them bolting this thing in from afar. Now, if you've been looking closely, you can see the electrical work is all installed on this. So it's already, look closely there, the silver tubing along the side there of the pre-drop, it's all installed. Very impressive. And again, this piece was about 60 tons that they were lifting into place. And look at this guy. Look at that guy, like, standing on the drop of Yukon Striker to help get this drop, pre-drop, connected together. Like, that's insane. Can you imagine? It's windy, guys. He's 223 feet in the air, helping get this thing aligned and installed. And look, like, he's doing it like it's like, you know, he's out for tea. So, absolutely insane. By the way, there is drone footage at the end of the video. I wanted to showcase this first because, again, first time using my Sony CyberShot like this, and I will be using it more often, especially picture taking. Wait till you see the pictures on Instagram and Facebook. Absolutely insane. It is like you are right there. Sorry for the shakiness. I am zoomed in. Like, as you can tell, like, you can make out these people's faces, and we are way back in a field. We're about like 400 feet away, 400, 500 feet away. I don't know. I could be overestimating that. No, yeah, I would say we're about 500 feet away. 500 feet away, and you are seeing this, like, you know, you're kind of like right there. So sorry about the shakiness. It was really cold. My hands were freezing. It was windy and super zoomed in. The more zoomed in you get, the more unstabilized the image becomes. So I apologize for that. But again, the images are absolutely phenomenal. So we're getting closer to it almost being installed. At this point, you can see it's actually connected and they were bolting in the drop to the pre-drop. And that's when he started to lower the back end of this whole section. So again, you have four track pieces all connected here with catwalks, electrical. Look at the speakers. There's speakers up there too. So that's really cool. Actually, I just noticed that there's speakers. Onboard audio? Not onboard audio on the train, but I wonder if they're going to do something like Banshee. It's a little, I don't know if, do they have speakers on Valraven? Comment down below if they have speakers on the top portion of the lift for the turn even on Valraven. That would be interesting. I wonder if there's going to be some sort of like, kind of like music up there or something, or kind of like a little storyline, a quick little like 5 second play storyline going on up there, or a eagle screech because it's supposed to be, you know, the eagle in the dive position. But yeah, hope you guys really enjoyed this footage. For the drone footage, I'm not going to do a voiceover because there's not much else to talk about. There's no new track, there's no new nothing, but it is great footage. It gives you definitely a better perspective. I actually brought the drone down to just under Behemoth's height. So right here for you guys to get a good perspective of this thing. Like, this thing's massive. Those are like office buildings behind it. The mountain is off to the right. Windseeker, you know, it's about 3/4 up Windseeker. So I wanted to get you a different perspective than when I normally fly higher. So hope you guys enjoy the drone footage. I would definitely watch it if you want to get a different perspective. Hopefully you like this video. Hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't, and share this video for others to enjoy. And stay tuned for the pictures that'll be released very shortly after we all watch this video for my first YouTube premiere. As always, thanks for watching, guys, and stay tuned for some awesome content in November. I am so excited for November. Have a good one, guys. Bye.